My name is Natasha Carmani. I'm here with the science fiction film Imitation Girl. It's my first feature, and this is our European premiere.
Natasha, it's fantastic to have you here at FrightFest. What does it mean for you to showcase the film specifically at this festival?
This is this is just really exciting for us. We're a science fiction film. We're not strictly horror, so we're kind of outliers on the genre. And I'm just so excited. I mean, Paul, Alan, everybody has been so incredibly welcoming. The passion that they feel for each and every single film is just really pretty rare and really special, I think, as a filmmaker to come and feel like you're in really capable hands. And it's just great to be here in London. We're really excited to share the film with beyond our borders. So it's just great to be here. As I said, we're a science fiction film. Basically, we follow the two storylines. One is an alien that comes to Earth and takes the shape of a real girl. So we have these two characters played by the incredible Lauren Ashley Carter. And the story kind of goes in a non-linear fashion, intertwining between these two storylines. And really what it's about is seeing two sides of a split identity. So sort of exploring both the yin and the yang of a single person. And that's really where we started. And from there, I just knew Lauren could step in and fill all of those shoes. She is just a monumental talent. She and I had been working together on some short form work for a few years prior. And when I started putting this piece together, it's my first feature. I just knew that I could rely on her and that I could lean on her and that she could lead this film. And that's exactly what she did. I mean, I know she's incredibly creative. She is smart as a whip and horribly, horribly funny. I mean, her humor is just off the charts. And for a film that's pretty heavy, that was really important to me. She's got a writer's spirit, so she comes with a lot of her own ideas. We actually needed her to learn a very difficult foreign language. and she just rose to the challenge. And I just knew she was going to be able to do it all. And she did.
Of all the genres of cinema, I think horror is one that almost has the worst reputation for being quite gender biased, both in the focus of stories and the people telling those stories. Can you talk a little bit, I guess, about, for you, how you feel about that, and also the fact that it is a distracting conversation, I guess?
It is. It is a distracting conversation. It doesn't feel especially relevant, you know, when you're just doing your thing. But as frustrating it is as it is to keep talking about it, it is an extremely important conversation to have. And I, with respect to genre, I think, you know, women love genre too, and you should work, you should play in the playground that you want to play in. And I grew up loving genre, science fiction, horror, and so that's where I want to be, and so that's where I go. But I think, you know, being a director is about really earning the respect of the people who are working with you and acknowledging that you are, in the end, a collaborator. You may come with an idea, but as soon as it gets out there into the world, it's everybody's project. So I think once you start treating other people with respect and, you know, showing that you know what you're doing, they'll treat you with respect too.
Nima Jirapci, actor in Imitation Girl. My character is the first guy to find the imitation, and I basically acclimate her to human society.
What was it about not only the role, but this script overall that really struck a chord with you?
Well, the role was interesting because it's an immigrant character, and immigrants, particularly in my experience and my family in the United States, you know, sometimes you get stuck in this weird position where you're not really fully acclimated to the new culture, you haven't really left the old culture behind, and I could sense that in this character. I really wanted to investigate that. The script at large was just so off the wall and bizarre, I thought, I have to be a part of that. That's so awesome. Who thought of this, you know? So I think that sci-fi fantasy, in particular science fiction, is really poised to make commentary on contemporary society because it can be so similar to it while giving us very pointed differences. You know what I mean? Take something like, you know, Orwell, the classic example, 1984, right? It's similar enough to where you can really relate to it, but it's different enough to where it really points a very specific finger to maybe some things that are problematic in our societies, things that we need to bring our attentions to, so.
You talk about your experiences working with your rather beautiful co-star.
Oh, yes, she was excellent, and I had rarely seen anyone with such hard work and dedication. You know, she, in a matter of 2 weeks, essentially learned a big chunk of a foreign language she had no context for whatsoever. And she, I mean, for weeks, would be coming over to my house, and we'd be going over Farsi lines over and over again. And it's admirable to be around that kind of dedication to work, you know? So it was good. You know, Natasha's got a really definite idea of what she wants out of her script and what out of her characters. But the thing that makes her a brilliant director is, you know, she casts the part and then lets you do what you need to do with it. You know what I mean? A lot of the scenes that ended up in the film were paraphrased or they were improvised. And this was something that she was really encouraging from us so that we could get these natural interactions. Because she knew that I could inhabit the character regardless of whether I was saying her words or not. You know what I mean? And it's, I think, sometimes rare to get that type of trust from a director in a film. So
you mentioned there are a lot of themes and subtext to this story. What are you most hoping overall an audience takes away from the film at the end?
Oh man, that's a hard question to answer. You know, ultimately I would just say I hope people are entertained. You know, when it all comes down to it, we're all entertainers. The movie's supposed to be fun, so I hope that people enjoy the experience, you know.
How does it feel to not only be a part of FrightFest, but to have platforms like this to showcase independent cinema?
That's awesome. I mean, this is why I entered the industry, you know, for stuff like this, where you can meet a community where everyone is so supportive of each other. I mean, it's amazing to be here, so.